I'm Judge Thomas Patrick from the Virginia Beach Circuit Court. I have been a judge for almost 19 years, and as part of my duties as a juvenile court judge, I was appointed by then Governor Allen to be on the Juvenile Justice Reform Commission. And I would say that was around 1994, somewhere in that range. And that was the first opportunity that I had to meet Chief Justice Hassell. And when I first met him, the first thing I noticed about him was that although he was on the Supreme Court and I was on the juvenile court bench, he was much younger than I was at the time. And I took a keen interest in him for many reasons, because I grew up in the Tidewater area, and I knew from talking with him that he was from the city of Norfolk and had grown up during the period of extreme segregation in our area, and that he had, from my first impression of him, being extremely bright, and that he had survived, for the lack of a better term, that terrible period in our history and had thrived. So I took an interest in him, and all of the contributions that he made were well thought out. For example, I think, well, what do I think about that? I've been on the juvenile court bench. He hasn't been on the juvenile court bench, but he seems to know a great deal of what we're talking about. So this interaction went on for, I think the committee met for a couple months. And then I didn't see him again for quite a while. I did notice that he had reviewed a couple of my cases. I should mention that in 1997, I was elevated to the circuit court bench. And again, I had not seen him, but he had done a couple of my cases, affirmed a couple of my rulings, which endeared him to me once again. But I always remember him, I remembered him at that point, that he was so well-versed in the law and very, he may impress me, as I've already said. And then several years later, I was appointed to the Committee on District Courts and subsequently became chairman. And we held regular meetings and I ran the meetings. And then about that time, well, I'm going to say I chaired it for maybe 3 or 4 years. And then Justice Hassell became Chief Justice Hassell. And one of the first things he did when he became Chief Justice, he showed up at our meetings. And you might think, well, you know, Chief Justice should be coming to the Committee on District Courts meetings because it's one of the two committees that actually run the court system, at least in theory. And so all of a sudden, there he is, and he's sitting next to me. Well, legally, strange as it might sound, he was not a member of the committee by law. The Virginia Code outlined who would be a member of that committee. And then after he had been there a couple times, and it was kind of difficult in that, not difficult, but difficult in a good way, because we would discuss things and try to decide, and then sooner or later we'd kind of look over at him and say, well, what do you think? Of course, he was running the entire court system. So after several of these meetings, he approached me in his great gentlemanly style, and he said, Tom, don't you think I should be chairman of this committee? And I said, well, of course, Mr. Chief Justice, whatever you think is appropriate. And of course it was appropriate, I thought. He says, well, you know, I'm going to have to get the law changed. Because as you know, the code says, specifies who are the members of the committee, and I'm not one of them. So sure enough, the General Assembly met maybe 9 months later. The law was changed and he became chairman of the Committee on District Courts. I became vice chairman, which was something else you mentioned. You know, we'll make you the vice chairman. And of course it was all volunteer. Anyway, so then we continued our tenure together, he being the chairman, me being the vice chairman. And some of these meetings frequently, it might not surprise you, become very boring. And we're like a couple of school kids sometimes. We would write notes back and forth about not necessarily what was being presented, but what we thought were important issues of the day. I mean, my favorite one was when the governor was going to appoint a new justice, I wrote down my opinion as to who I thought was going to be the new justice, and passed it over to him, and he wrote me another note, well, you know, do you have some inside information or something, which of course I didn't. And well, it turns out I was right. And the person that I had suspected was going on the court became a later addition to the court. He took an extreme interest in our committee, as he did for just about everything he touched. He made the committee more diverse. He asked questions that were important as to the diversity of our committee, segmented dockets. Many courts would, for example, start at 9 a.m. And if you had a case, you had to be in court at 9 a.m. with everybody else who had a case that day. So it was like a cattle call. So he ensured, among other things, that every district court, when I say district court, I include juvenile court, would have a segmented docket so that you could schedule something, say, at 9 o'clock, 11 o'clock, 2 o'clock, and yes, even 3:30. And it was somewhat unpopular by many with many judges because, well, they, you know, they wanted everyone to work on their schedule. They were more the exception than the rule because our judges are very conscientious. But that was just one thing that he took an interest in. And if I could, if I had to tell you everything he took an interest in, I think, quite frankly, I'd be droning on and on and on, and then perhaps others perhaps would have repeated me. There's another thing I should mention about Chief Justice, Chief Justice Estelle, on a personal note. As I said, I'm from Virginia Beach, and there is a world-renowned gym in Virginia Beach called Waring's Gym. And when he had business in Virginia Beach, invariably he would end up at Waring's Gym, where I was also a member, although I never saw him there, but I always heard when he was there. And what I mean by that, he was a powerful man, that he would wow these gym rats as to the amount of weight he could bench press. He was just so well-rounded, such a great guy, and such a professional, and we truly miss him. And I felt that I should just give you my personal remembrances of him. He was a distinguished jurist and served the Commonwealth better than just about anyone I could imagine, especially considering his humble roots in Norfolk.